Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Melissa, your host, and today we're going to be talking about EDM, specifically EDM through the perspective of the DJ, the artist. Today here is my friend DJ Fly. He likes to be called Fly, just like that. And let's just get started. What is your musical background?
Well, growing up, I had a lot of musical backgrounds. My parents both being Spanish, my dad being from Puerto Rico, my mom being from Colombia. So there's a lot of salsa merengue in the house growing up. Early ages, I was always into hip-hop music. I heard that a lot growing up. And I was always the one making mixtapes and stuff and handing them out to the friends. So big influence there growing up.
Yeah, sounds like it. So you had more of your roots in the Latin sounds?
Yeah, growing up, when I actually first started DJing, I actually did more Latin music than electronic music. It kind of grew at me growing up. So yeah.
Awesome. What attracted you to being a DJ?
Just the whole fact of me being into music growing up. I had a friend that used to DJ, and I used to go around with him to the different venues, and he kind of showed me the ropes, and you know, it looked really fun, and I wanted to do more than just listen to the music, kind of wanted to spread it on a bigger audience, so he kind of showed me the ropes and showed me how to DJ, and I mean, that's how it all started.
Yeah, sounds awesome. So he just like show you the behind the scenes and you kind of like fell in love with it? Or?
Yeah, he showed me, you know, how to read the crowd and how to use the equipment, and you know, it just, from there, it was like second nature.
Wow. So which one you prefer to use as a mixing board? What kind of brand do you usually do?
Well, the standard would be the CDJs. Those are the standards that you go in any venue that they'll have, CDJs and USBs.
Okay, awesome. How do you start the composition process?
For me, it's all by ears. It's stuff that will stick out to you, stuff that sounds different. You always kind of want to stay up to date with music and what's being played out there. And definitely, if you can hear a different sound, I think that's one of the biggest things. It's all by ear. For me, it's all by ear. It's just stuff that'll stick out. Like, oh, I'm going to play this tonight because I feel like this is really going to catch people's attention. Okay. Stuff like that is really important when you're performing so you can get that crowd reaction.
Right. Does it always go well?
For the most part, yeah. As long as you prepare.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, there could be instances where you show up to a club and it's totally different from what you planned. But, I mean, then even there, you just have to work with what you got.
Yeah, absolutely. That will be one of my fears. It's like, oh, it's not going well. Okay, switch. Do you see yourself as an idol for the new generations?
Yeah, I wouldn't really consider myself as an idol. I would just consider myself as a big community. From promoters to DJs to other artists to club venue owners to ticket sales and just about anything. It's a big community. I think we all play a part in spreading music as a whole. So right. Not as an idol, I think more as just part of the family.
That sounds awesome, actually. What influenced you as an artist?
I think just knowing that you're there to help people have fun. I think that you're there to help people enjoy their night. You know, people come to venues and clubs and shows kind of just to forget about everything else for those 3-4 hours and just have fun. And for you being a part of that and you kind of orchestrating their night, I think that's one of the biggest things for me that I enjoy.
Absolutely. So you're the puppet master kind
yeah,
of thing.
Yeah, kind
pulling
of.
All those trains.
That's right.
Walk me through a productive day in your shoes.
Okay, well, it's definitely something that's behind the scenes that a lot of people don't see. Anywhere from, you know, countless hours of researching music, downloading music, to listening to other people, what they're playing, to even doing research online and see what's popular, you know, purchasing music. It's just so much that takes into effect. Even putting music in keys. I mean, I'm not sure if a lot of people know how, that DJs
I don't think they know at all.
Yeah, so, you know, each song has a key, so when you put music in key, that means they transition better together.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so there's programs and stuff that help you do that, but you can still, you know, plan your sets together and just stuff like that people not aware of don't know that, you know, they're really time consuming, but at the end of the day pays off.
What do you think of your fans?
I think I see them more as supporters. I don't really see them as fans. I think I just see them more of people that, you know, support what you do, come out and have fun. I mean, it's, I think one of the best things as a DJ is somebody just coming up to you and just like, hey, you know, I had such a great time because of you, or, you know, I had, you know, great music up there, you know, I love what you do. Like, I don't like calling them fans. I don't like putting myself above somebody else. I think it's just more of a support system, and I think that anybody needs that, not just DJs. Anybody needs a good support system, and I think they're one of the reasons why a lot of people are motivated to do what they do.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the fan is the heart of what you do too, you know, because
right.
The people that are there, it's like a, I don't know, a relationship in the moment. You have to see how they react, and then,
right,
you know, yeah. Hopefully they'll come back every
yeah.
time they hear your name.
Yeah, you get a lot of connections with strangers
yeah.
by being a DJ. Like, you know, you make a lot of eye contact. You may not even know who they are.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I love your music. Oh, you know, and that's really fulfilling. So, it's really important.
Are you like an extroverted person or more introverted person? So, because like being a DJ, you have to be like out there with them, you know, pretty much. And you know, do you see yourself like, do you hide behind your booth or you pretty much express yourself?
Oh no, when I'm up there, I'm having fun.
Yeah.
You know, I'm clapping, I'm cheering, I'm fist pumping, I'm jumping. Like, I think crowd interaction is really big. It's really important. Like, I don't think anybody wants to just see a DJ sit there and just look at the crowd. I think you have to be more connected with your audience.
Yeah.
So for me, that's a big thing. You know, I'll catch myself shuffling back there sometimes. I'm just having a good time.
Is your music intended to be listened to in a higher state of mind?
I think overall, you can just basically, I don't think there's a specific state of mind that you need to listen to it in. I think it's just the stuff I play is just really like good vibe stuff, really, really, you know, makes you feel good, makes you want to dance. I think in any state of mind, it could be in the car, at a club, while you're doing your homework,
okay.
Anything. I think you just, as long as you feel like listening to music, I think any environment would be okay for you.
Yeah, absolutely. What do you think of the recreational or perhaps spiritual drugs?
I think that as far as recreational or spiritual drugs, I think if that's what you choose to do and that's what you're intended to want to do while you're out, that's totally fine. I don't judge you for doing stuff like that. One thing I do think is that I don't think you should be dependent on that to have a good time.
Yeah.
I think that you should be able to go out, you know, and have a good time without doing those types of things. Because it should be more about the music more than anything, more about the feeling. So, I mean, if you do it, that's totally fine. I mean, I don't judge you for that at all, but if you don't, then, you know, more kudos to you.
Yeah. Do you try to change society and culture with your work?
I don't really think about society or culture when working or music and DJing and stuff. I think I leave that all to whatever resources that they want to, if it's the media or the news. I think I just, the type of music I play is, like I said, it's just something that kind of takes you away from everything for a little while. I think it just gives you hopefully good feelings, good vibes while you're at the venue or at the club for
yeah.
3-4 hours and you just forget about everything else.
Yeah, absolutely. What kind of message, if any, do you try to deliver with each concert?
Well, it's definitely a big responsibility when you're out there playing, you know, for people. You're kind of in charge of the music. I think the only one of the messages I think that is just like we're all really equal. I mean, there's a lot of stuff going out there in the media. There's a lot of stuff going on, president election, I think if anything, music should unite us as people. I think music is a universal language you can hear anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, different languages, but you know, it's still, you can still hear a beat. So I think more than anything, I think when people listen to music, I think it should bring them together, because there's no discrimination, there's no racism, it's just music.
Right.
And I think that's how it should be on an everyday basis.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think especially EDM is the type of music that just doesn't really it's just cultural, yeah, you know, like...
it doesn't have a type of crowd.
Yeah, it doesn't have a type of crowd, because you could borrow from so many other rhythms, so you could have a hip-hop part, and you could have a rock even part on your set, and you could have all kinds of, like, even Spanish or whatever language you want to put into it, you know, and it just creates, like, a melting pot of races, and so it creates, like, a safe haven for everybody to party, pretty much.
Yeah.
So I read about Deadmau5 yesterday. He did an interview with Rolling Stones where he said that EDM was dead. Do you care to have an opinion on that, perhaps?
Yeah, I don't necessarily think it's dead. I think it's just a point where it's evolved and a little more mainstream. I think it's evolved more than Deadmau5 would have wanted, as far as it being out in the media more. Get more of this pop stuff, which is totally fine. I mean, Deadmau5 is one of my favorite artists. I've seen him countless of times, and I really enjoy his music. I don't think it's dead, though. I think just more people respectfully are getting the attention that they should. Even the genre EDM is getting more attention, as it should. You know, artists like DJ Snake and Diplo and Skrillex and even Bieber's going to EDM, you know.
Yeah.
So I don't necessarily think it's dead. I think it's just really evolved. I think it's grown more for the masses. I think it's more public now. It's more mainstream. You can hear it on your radio now.
Yeah. Actually, I hear it at my job all the time, actually. So, and we're in an Italian restaurant, so.
Yeah. I walk into stores. I walk into the mall store, just like chain stores, and near EDM now, and it's cool.
It's actually really cool. I really enjoy it. I don't think it's dying. Like you said, it's becoming more popular and it's becoming noticeable. And it's a type of music you know, it's hard not to like. You know, you got your favorite pop artists or pop songs or even hip-hop lyrics and, you know, and mixed with a great tune and, you know, awesome bass. So it's hard not to like it. What is your reaction of the mocking that people saying that suggests that all you do is just punch buttons?
Yeah, I mean, I hear that a lot. I mean, people have their own opinions, but I mean, like kind of said before, I mean, there's so much more behind the scenes that people don't see, you know, countless hours of just researching music, downloading music. I mean, they could see you just get to a venue and just start playing buttons, but I mean, you have a lot more responsibility than that. You know, you're in control basically of the whole night. I mean, it's basically on your shoulder for them to have a good time.
Yeah.
You know, so I think it just the aspect of you having to go up there by yourself and play music, I think that's just a big enough responsibility as it is. I mean, a lot of people won't see that, but I mean, granted, they get up there, I'm sure they'll be a little nervous.
Yeah, I don't know if I can do that.
Yeah.
But yeah, more kudos to you. You get up there and make the party start.
Right.
Okay, what do you dislike the most, if anything, of your career choice?
I couldn't really say that there's anything that I dislike about, you know, I think everybody has a choice to do what makes them happy. You know, I think you have an opportunity, you know, everybody should have an opportunity for them to do something they enjoy, you know, something that they look forward to doing. And DJing is something I look forward to doing. I don't see it as a job. I see it more as a hobby, something more as a thrill, something to have fun. So I can't really say there's anything that I dislike about it. You know, I like that it's evolving. I like it that more artists are getting more recognition, as they should, because they put hours and craft into their time. So.
I know this is not all my questions, but I was thinking, which would be the ultimate venue for you to play? Like, which would be the festival or venue that you like to play at?
I would like to play in Ibiza.
Ibiza?
Yeah. I would love, they have really great parties.
Yeah, I know. That's actually one of my dreams, to go to Ibiza and this party there for like a whole week.
Yeah, I think that would be the ultimate for me, playing in Ibiza.
So not a specific festival, but...
just being there.
Just being there. I think you can manage that.
Hopefully, one day.
Make some calls. Final thought. What do you say to those that told you you will never succeed as a professional DJ, or if you ever face such animosity?
Yeah, I think overall I've always had a good support system. I can't recall somebody saying, no, don't do it because I don't think it's good, or I don't think you'll make I think overall I've been grateful to have a good support system in whatever decisions I choose to do. I don't measure success by money or fame. I think as long as you're doing what you love to do, I think you succeeded already.
Yeah.
And I think overall that you can take that into consideration with everything you do. So I just feel like, you know, if you wake up, you know, and you have to DJ and you love to DJ and it's just something that you look forward to doing, then you didn't fail.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Hey, I love your response. Thank you so much for coming and answering all my questions. Thank you all guys for watching. Stay tuned. Please like my videos. Please follow. Bye-bye.
Later.